Hi everyone. So today we will be learning one of the most important chapter, that is shock. Okay, shock and fluid therapy. In this class we will discuss about shock and its pathophysiology and its classification and etc. about shock. Next class we will go for fluid therapy. First of all, shock. Okay, what does shock mean or what happens in shock? There is a decrease in effective blood flow and also decrease in oxygen delivery. Okay, the better definition of shock is this one. The shock can be defined as an imbalance between oxygen delivery and oxygen consumption, such that the delivery of oxygen does not meet the demand by the tissues. Okay, this is the definition of shock. Next, classification of shock. You see, there are two types of classification. There is also a third one, but that is not so popular. The traditional one and the functional one. Okay, first of all, the traditional one. First is cardiogenic shock. As the name suggests, cardiogenic means it originates from heart. So there is decrease in myocardial contractility. There may be any type of pathology of heart, whether it is infarction or any conduction problem, anything. The originate from heart. Okay, so there is a decrease in myocardial contractility, decrease in heart rate, decrease in cardiac output, and will go under shock. Next one is hypovolemic or hemorrhagic. Sometimes also this is called also a surgical shock, because there in surgery there is loss of blood. Okay, so hypovolemic or hemorrhagic, that means the intravascular, there is decrease in IV volume. Okay, it can happen in three ways: whether there is loss of blood, plasma, or water. Okay, example of blood loss is, you know, accidental injury or trauma. The best example of plasma loss is burn wound or scald, burning or scalding, in which there is loss of plasma. And water is the best example, is diarrhea, diabetes mellitus. Okay, these are the example of hypovolemic shock. Next one is septic shock. You see, these two are kind of similar. Okay, in which there is damage to the capillary, damage to capillary system. In septic shock, it is mostly because of infectious origin. Okay, you see example of a traumatic shock. Suppose you have bitten an animal very hard. Okay, you will find much of capillary bed damaged. So there will be less venous return, which will lead to hypovolemia. I will discuss the vicious cycle of hypovolemia later on. You will understand how this traumatic or inflammatory response causes hypovolemia. Okay. Next, if this is anaphylactic reaction, this is because of any allergen. This anaphylactic reaction may be two types, whether it is immunogenic, in which immunoglobulin E is involved, IgE. Next is non-immunogenic. Okay, in both of the phenomenon, it will lead to release of histamine. Okay, histamine is a potent bronchoconstrictor. It will block the airway, which may lead into shock. Next, this is more accepted or most recent classification. Okay, functional classification. First one is hypovolemic. This is same as here. There is a reduction in IV volume, intravascular volume. Same example. Okay, loss of blood, plasma, or water. Next, cardiogenic it is also same as this one, there is decrease in myocardial contractility. Maybe some pathology of heart, this is better dealt in medicine. Next, vasogenic, this means this originates from pathology of vessels. Here you see septic shock, the sepsis comes under vasogenic, traumatic, endotoxemia. These are examples in which there will be vasogenic shock. You see why these vessels are endotheliums are attacked, because you know the endothelium has only one lining. Okay, this is basement membrane, these are epithelium, only single line, they are easily damaged. Next is obstructive, there is any kind of obstruction like pulmonary thromboembolism, cardiac tamponade, gastric dilatation and volvulus, this also comes under obstructive shock. Okay, these are basically functional classifications of shock, traditional and functional, these two. There is also a classification of primary and secondary, but that is not important. These two you remember this with their examples, you can write in the long question. Shock can come as a long question. Now we will understand neurohormonal response, that means when there will be hypovolemia, what body does to restore its volume? We will understand one by one. First of all, you take a screenshot of this chart. Okay. Now we will understand one by one. When there will be hypovolemia, there will be decrease in cardiac output. When there will be decrease in cardiac output, the kidneys, there will be less perfusion to kidneys. When there will be less blood supply to the kidneys, it will activate the RAS, renin angiotensin aldosterone system. Okay, RAS activation. Then when there will be RAS activation, it will function as increase in sodium and water retention. This will increase the IV volume and cardiac output. Second, when there will be hypovolemia or loss of plasma, there will be decrease in osmomolality. When there will be decrease in osmomolality, the hypothalamus will be triggered. It will release adrenocorticotropic hormone, ACTH, which will act on adrenal gland to secrete aldosterone, cortisol and epinephrine. Okay. The aldosterone is responsible, will act on kidneys to increase in the sodium and water retention. Also, that aldosterone is a potent vasoconstrictor. Okay. It will constrict the blood vessels. Next, the cortisol, it will function on the it will act on liver to synthesis glucose, so that there will be energy production, protein synthesis, mostly the albumin and globulin. Okay, the albumin and globulin, they are the main proteins which maintain the osmolality of blood vessels. Next, there will be epinephrine release. Epinephrine is a potent vasoconstrictor, so there will be vasoconstriction. Also, it has a positive, you see, increase in heart rate is known as chronotropic effect. And increase in heart muscle contractility or myocardial contractility is known as inotropic effect. So, epinephrine has both chronotropic and inotropic effect, which will further increase the intravascular volume and cardiac output. Next, the hypothalamus controls the pituitary gland also. So, under the command of hypothalamus, pituitary will select the release antidiuretic hormone. Okay, this also increases the water retention and sodium retention, which will further increase the IV volume and cardiac output. Next, when there will be hypovolemia, the baroreceptor, there will be loss of baroreceptor stretch. Where the baroreceptor is present, mostly the artery, specifically the carotid artery. Okay. When there will be loss of baroreceptor stretch, the medulla oblongata will be triggered, which will release the norepinephrine. Mostly this is known as sympathetic release. The sympathetic release of norepinephrine. The function of norepinephrine is same as epinephrine, which will cause vasoconstriction, and it has positive chronotropic and inotropic effect, which will further increase the IV volume and cardiac output. This is the response of the body when there is hypovolemia. But if you are not interfering as a doctor here, the hypovolemia, there will be vicious cycle. Now we will understand what is vicious cycle. Now the vicious cycle. Okay. When there will be hypovolemia, there will be decrease in cardiac output, which will in turn reduce the blood pressure. When there will be less blood pressure, the tissues getting blood flow will be reduced. There will be poor tissue perfusion. When there will be poor tissue perfusion, the venous return will be reduced, which will further decrease the hypovolemia. This is the vicious cycle. Also, when there will be poor tissue perfusion, there will be release of inflammatory mediator like interleukins and cytokinins. Okay, these will act on heart to further reduce the cardiac output. So this is basically the vicious cycle. So where you can break? This is the only thing through which you can break the vicious cycle. When we are administering the fluids from an external source or through venous route, then this vicious cycle can be break. So now the clinical signs and stages of some. The stages are mostly three: the compensatory, early decompensatory or terminal. First one is compensatory stage. In this stage the body responses to shock. The neurohormonal response, which I discussed previously, there will be an increase in cardiac output, heart rate and vascular resistance, that is vasoconstriction. I already explained how this works. Next, what will clinical signs you will get? There will be slight increase. This is mild increase, actually mild increase in heart rate and respiration rate. The mucous membrane will be brick red in color, and the CRT, the capillary refill time, will be less than 1 second. That means that there will be some or mild degree of dehydration, or then there may not be any dehydration. The blood pressure will be normal, and the mentation or the mental state of animal will be fine. You see how you can measure the blood pressure. You see, there is no device in field level. What you can do, you simply try to raise the vein. Okay, raising the vein. Okay, you usually give your intravenous fluid in saphenous or cephalic. Okay, you block the vessels and see how fast they are rising up. By that you can not correctly, but up to some extent you can know the blood pressure. Next is early decompensatory. You see, this phase will be in field level. The parvo cases will be presenting mostly. The avid owner, they know that they will be presented in this stage. But when some the pet parents which are becoming parents for her first time, or some desi dogs or non-descript dog owners, they will bring their animal after 2 to 3 days. Most of the time the dog will be in this stage. Okay, so the early decompensatory, in which there will be redistribution of blood flow, which will the redistributed towards the vital organs only, the heart, brain or lungs. Okay, there will be development of lactic acidosis because of less oxygen delivery. You see, why lactic acidosis? Because of anaerobic glycolysis. See, when there will be aerobic glycolysis, the end product is pyruvic acid. Okay, pyruvate is also known, pyruvate or pyruvic acid. But when there is anaerobic glycolysis without the oxygen, the end product is lactic acid. Okay, so development of lactic acidosis, and which signs you will get? The tachycardia, fast heart rate, tachypnea, higher respiration rate, mucous membrane will be pale, the capillary refill time will be more than 1 second, and there will be development of hypothermia and hypotension. You see these two, if you have attended any parvo case which have presented after 2 to 3 days, these two will be there. Okay, most of the time the temperature won't be above 98 degree Fahrenheit or 99 degree Fahrenheit. Sometimes they come up to the 97 degree Fahrenheit. This phenomena I have seen in my own dog also. On the third day, we were giving fluids. On third day, when I recorded the temperature, okay, the temperature was 97 degree Fahrenheit. After giving some colloids and crystalloids, the temperature and hypotension was corrected. Okay, I will discuss the fluid therapy in next class. Okay, next, decompensatory or terminal stage. If the animal reaches this stage, there it is very difficult to revive the animal back into life. Most of the time they die also. The body will give up autoregulatory escape. Okay, the sympathetic center will be lost, there will be loss of chronotropic and inotropic effect. Okay, then you will see as a clinical manifestation, heart rate will be very very low, and there will be absence of CRT and severe hypotension. Even if you apply the tourniquet, the vein will not be raised. Okay, so this is this last stage. After that, death. This is all about shock, its classification, stages, signs, the pathophysiology, everything. This is all about shock. Next class we will go for fluid therapy, that is the types of fluids like crystalloid, colloid, blood, their dose rates, and combination therapy, etc. Their composition, I will tell some commercially available fluids and their compositions, when to use, balanced electrolyte solution, everything. Next class. So this is all about shock. Thank you. Bye-bye.